We also want to set the above frayed wall to 12 inches of heavyweight concrete. And for glass, we're simply going to keep the east doors to 0 and the west doors to 0. We'll keep the default glass inputs for height and width and type. When we look at the shell, you'll see what this does later. We're going to only model one glass type. And so we take one of these glass types and click select another. This is something that's probably pretty familiar to most of you. We're going to model the north wall, so that we can get a starting point when we model our glass. We're not going to have any overhangs, and we click next, and we get screen 11 here because we had daylighting selected to yes. We make a note here that all of the zones that are daylit are in green and the non-daylit zones are in white. And if you notice further, the little dots here, these are the daylighting sensors, and they happen to coincide with all of the north walls. If you recall, we had only selected the north walls to have glass, so eQuest automatically put the photocell sensor into the north rooms. You may ask, well, what about